Hi, good morning to all. In this session, we have to discuss about external treatment of water. Already we have discussed ion exchange resins. Now we have to discuss about permutic process or zeolite process. So what is in this zeolite? Zeolite is an inorganic material that is made up of aluminosilicates. So these zeolites have to be used to treat water externally before feeding that into boilers. So that process, before going to that process, we have to know about more on that zeolite or a permutic process. Sodium aluminosilicates are called as zeolites, and chemical formula for zeolite is given here. So sometimes we can synthesize that zeolite in laboratory. That zeolites are called as permutic. That means permutic means that zeolites which is synthesized in laboratory, that means artificial zeolites. Zeolite means sodium aluminosilicates available naturally. That is the basic important material to be used in this process. So these zeolites already explained two types. One is natural zeolites. We are deriving these zeolites from green sand. They are having non-porous. Example is netrolite. Next one is synthetic zeolites. We are synthesizing these zeolites from laboratory, and these zeolites are having more porous and they may have jelly like structure. So what is the procedure to prepare this? So to prepare this, we have to heat china clay with feldspar and soda ash. Then these zeolites are having high exchange capacity per unit weight than the natural zeolites. That means we can, by using these synthetic zeolites, we can exchange more volume of water molecules, that means hot water. Process is given here. So here one bed is there, that is called as a zeolite bed. So this zeolite bed is made up of sodium aluminosilicates, that means sodium ions are there. So simply we can represent this zeolite as Na2Ze. Now that water, hot water, is allowed to pass through this zeolite bed. While passing, that sodium ions present on the surface of the zeolite is exchanged with the calcium or magnesium ions present in that hot water. So all the spots in the zeolite bed is now exchanged with that calcium magnesium ions. That means all the sodium ions present in that zeolite bed is exchanged with the calcium or magnesium ions present in that hot water. So all sodium ions are given out. So that zeolites are saturated with the calcium or a magnesium ions present in that hot water. That reaction is given here. Sodium zeolites with the calcium bicarbonate, we are getting calcium zeolites. So that sodium bicarbonate is water soluble and it has been removed. Same as here also, that with the calcium chloride, so calcium zeolites will be formed. So calcium sulfate, calcium zeolites will be formed. In case of magnesium salts, we are getting magnesium zeolites. So all of these anions are removed. That means cations are removed and anions cannot be removed by this process. So the water which is coming outlet is free from calcium and magnesium, but it may have sodium chlorides, sodium bicarbonates or sodium sulfates. Next, that surface of zeolite is now saturated with the calcium and magnesium ions. So if after saturation of these zeolites, we cannot continue this process. So to continue this process, we have to regenerate that sodium ions in the zeolite bed. So we have to wash that with sodium chloride. So calcium magnesium salts has been removed as their respective chlorides, and sodium ions are reproduced on the surface of the zeolite. Then sodium aluminosilicates will be formed again. So that 10% sodium chloride solution which is used to wash this sodium aluminosilicate bed is called as a brine. That means 10% NaCl is called as a brine. That means 10 gram in 100 ml of water, that is called as a 10% sodium chloride brine solution. Advantages: in this process, that low sludge is formed. So here that water is coming out from this process is nearly zero hardness, so that operation of this process is very easy. And to generate this permutite, that cost is very cheap, because we can generated permutite, we can use it again and again. Many time we can use this permutite to treat more volume of water. So this equipment consumes a very small space. So these are the main advantages. So disadvantage, we cannot use this for water if that water is turbid. That means you cannot use this water for, we cannot use this process for turbid water as well as acidic water, because that acid as well as turbid may destroy the zeolite bed. We cannot use that. So in this process we can remove only cations. That means only calcium and magnesium ions can be replaced with the sodium ions of that zeolite bed. Remaining anions like bicarbonates, chlorides cannot be removed by this method. That is very, very, very important disadvantage. Sometimes that CO2 will be liberated. That CO2 may produce pressure. So it is another kind of disadvantage. Next, the formation of sodium hydroxide in this process, that water may be alkaline sometimes because that water contains sodium hydroxide. So if that water is having other than calcium or magnesium, we cannot treat this. That means we cannot treat if that water contains iron or manganese. So these ions cannot be removed. That is another important process. In summary, again we have to discuss this. So we are using zeolites. If that zeolite is available naturally, then that is called as zeolites. If we are preparing that in lab, then that is called as a permutite. We can use either zeolites or a permutite. Permutite is having more efficiency than that zeolites. So we are pouring that water, that sodium ions from the under that zeolite bed is used to exchange that calcium magnesium ions from that hot water. So after a particular time, that all the sodium ions are given out. That means all the sodium ions are exchanged with the calcium or magnesium. So now we have to regenerate that sodium. Because of that, we have to wash that by with 10% NaCl. If you wash that zeolite bed with 10% zeolite, then we are regenerating that sodium ions on the aluminosilicate, that means zeolite bed. We can reuse it again. So advantage and disadvantage also we have discussed now.